Hi everyone, welcome to this session from UPES School of Design. I'm Soumitro Bhattacharya, coordinator of graphic design at the UPES School of Design. School of Design at UPES offers undergraduate and postgraduate programs in creative disciplines taught by highly experienced faculty from premier institutes as well as by industry professionals. We offer product design, transportation design, interior and retail space design, and fashion design. We also offer graphic design, animation and VFX, interaction design, and game design. Please log on to www.upes.ac.in for any further information that you would like to know. We have with us today Mr. Anthony Lopez, founder and chief creative director at Lopez Design, with its head office in Gurgaon. He is a brand consultant, branding expert, communication strategist, design leader, and educator. Lopez Design is a full-service multidisciplinary design studio with diverse offerings in three core areas: strategy, design, and activation. His design studio specializes in areas of brand strategy and communications, wayfinding, and signage systems, experience design, spatial design, packaging design, and service design, and of course many other things. Now let's hear from Mr. Lopez about his journey, his experience. After he is done, I will have a set of questions myself that I would like to ask him. Meanwhile, you can type in your questions that you would have under the Q&A section. And I will take those questions a little later after the presentation is over and my questions are over. I'm sure some of your questions also be answered, you know, through whatever I ask him. So, Anthony, please, over to you. I think your audio is...
Hi everybody, so this is Anthony as introduced by Mr. Bhattacharya, and excuse me for the very long and illustrious titles which I got. It is just that I'm interested in doing many things, and the word for this is ambidextrous, so I'm not an expert in anything and I'm not a master in everything, but I do a lot of things. So. And because of that, my thinking has been shaped in that manner, in matter of speaking. So I'm going to take you through this presentation of mine, which I have truncated. I'm going to take you through some aspects of my journey, both basically as a person. And as a designer and as a practitioner, and also some of our work and because of which basically our work has been shaped in that sense. Sorry, I have to first share my screen. I'll do that. Can you see my screen?
Yes.
What can you read on the screen?
New York City sewer.
Yeah, in India. So I've been showing this slide for the past 10-15 years, you know, since I started making presentations. And I think basically it's important that that we as creators and as designers change the perception of India in many, many ways. And although India is well known around the world for many, many things, and I think we are changing, in the process of changing, but a lot more needs to be done in context, showcase what we are really, really good at as people and as experts and as communicators. And I think there is a huge possibility there. I'll keep showing you these slides in between, which will happen reasonably often. So it is where you're meant to blink. That means one topic is over, a new topic is starting, and probably a new dream sequence is starting. So this basically happened when we got in these two puppies about almost now a year back and into our lives. And these are basically Zach and Cody, whom we took them. But when we brought Zach and Cody into our lives, it turned out to be a nightmare. It turned out to be a anyway, they were shit anyway. And my entire family's life became inside out, in handling these two little puppies. And we said, what mistake have we done? And both of these are boys. So they fight with each other like crazy and they bite into each other and they bleed each other. But the initial days were terrible, but we were also hugely in love with them and it changed our life totally differently. So the question to you is that can we bring Jacks and Codys into our life? Not literally puppies and dogs, but can we keep on changing our lives by bringing disruptions so that it creates new love, new openings for us and new ways of looking at things, because till so many years, I was a very independent person. I never had to take care of anything in my life. I always had people taking care of me in return. And here I had to take care of these two little puppies. And it changed me in many, many ways, in that sense. So, So this is what they are now. So this is me during my COVID period, lockdown period. And Jack and Cody have grown big. They are almost a year old now. They normally hang around in the studio. We kept them away today so that we could have a continuous meeting today with you guys. Okay, so we are blinking again. So this is what our studio looks like. So it's a new studio and I normally don't show my studio to anybody. But since we came to this studio, it became popular because it's a good looking studio. Our previous studio was equally good looking, but it was it belonged to a landlord and we had several landlords at that point of time, three landlords, so different rooms. But here this is one very large, spacious this thing. And we designed it with an architect, but very closely. And this is our living space. We live here, and we live and work here. But I'll tell you why I'm showing off this studio to you very soon. I'm showing off the studio for this wall on the right. Can you see this wall on the right? There's some design on it, cast in concrete. Swamitra, can you see that?
Yes.
Yeah. So the design which is there on that wall is this design. Okay, it's cast in concrete and it's done by this intern who had come to our studio, Deepika Tiwari. So I saw her making these very beautiful little, very natural drawings, of human figures. These are all human figures. And I said, can we create something with human figures and nature? And this is what she produced. And I gave her a line, a quote, which says, I don't know if you can see it, which says, we are all born with genius.
Uh-huh. Yes.
Okay. And this is basically the core thinking behind our studio. I sincerely believe that each one of us, including me and you, each one of you, is born with genius. And I can give the first prize of somebody who can tell me whose quotation is this. Okay. And one clue is this genius himself just died about 3-4 days back, Yeah, and he's from New York and now the price is no longer valid unless you have got a message on my phone with your name. This is the guy who created I Love New York, And this is his quotation. And because I know that most of you have just joined the School of Design or are very young, it is important for us to how do I get rid of this? Just a sec. cursor disappears. Yeah, so it says, so we are all born with genius. It's like a fairy godmother. But what happens in life is that we stop listening to our inner voices. We no longer have access to our extraordinary ability to create poetry. And in a lot of ways, we all know what it means, that somehow, as children, we have so much of freedom and so much of creativity and so much of ingenuity within ourselves. And as we grow up, we somehow lose it, you know. And for most of us, we cannot bring it back. But I strongly believe that once you are inducted in the school of design, that is where you can bring it back for yourself. And it's very, very important that you protect yourself from everything else which disturbs this inner voice of yours. You know, you have to stay authentic and original to yourself. Kam se kam apne aap ke liye sachchai se jiyo. You know, and that sachchai is basically listening to your inner voice. Very important. Okay.
Very true.
We're going to blink again. So I'll very quickly go through these slides because this is something which I believe in very, very strongly. I think we have to reimagine design. So as you learn design, it's very important that you blink on all the definitions of design which has been taught to you. You know, and that is one thing. So reimagine design. And the other thing is reimagine design through India, because we are all Indians and we have to think through India. India ke andar se sochna socho, you know. Don't think, see what is happening in the West and then say, okay, what should I do here because of what is happening in the West? Because there's enough happening here. And we need to make sure that how we can take all what is happening in here in the current times with our DNA, jo aapke andar DNA hai, wo bahut knowledgeable hai. Through that, basically, how can you think design? I think it is the most misunderstood among the converted. So, jo gyani hai design wale, हमारे जैसे उनको खुद समझ में नहीं आता है कि क्या डिजाइन होता है बिकॉज वी आर टू मच इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द वेस्ट यू नो सो यू विल सी एंड रीड लॉट ऑफ आर्टिकल्स अबाउट दीज थिंग्स नाउ सरफेसिंग दैट द वेस्टर्न आइडियोलॉजी ऑफ वन साइज फिट ऑल यू नो डज नॉट वर्क इन इंडिया इंडिया इज 100 कंट्रीज यू नो सो व्हेन वी वर बॉर्न एज अ कंट्री बिफोर दैट वी वर 1000 स्टेट्स एंड ऑल दोस 1000 स्टेट्स वर फाइटिंग विद ईच अदर हम एक इंडिया नहीं थे हम लड़ झगड़ रहे थे एक दूसरे के साथ हम बहुत ही अलग थे एक दूसरे से बट फॉर सम मिरेकल बिकॉज ऑफ द ब्रिटिशर्स वी कैन गिव देम सम क्रेडिट वी हैव ऑल कम टुगेदर यू नो एंड वी आर स्टेइंग टुगेदर बट वी हैव टू रिस्पेक्ट द डाइवर्सिटी हाउ डू यू क्रिएट प्रोडक्ट्स हाउ डू यू क्रिएट कम्युनिकेशन हाउ डू यू क्रिएट थिंग्स विच बिलोंग टू एवरीबडी एंड रिस्पेक्ट्स देयर इंटीग्रिटी एज फार एज कल्चर्स आर कंसर्न एंड सब कल्चर्स आर कंसर्न द लैंग्वेजेस यू नो हाउ डू यू टच पीपल सो What I believe is that one size does not fit all in India. We'll have to create lots of things, lots of products which are fitting to people, fitting to different tribes of people in our country. Right. And thereby, basically, another aspect which I talk about very passionately is that it's a powerful strategic tool, and if comprehended, used effectively. So whatever you do as designers. Please give it a lot of importance as a strategic tool because it makes difference to society. Once it is out there, it is impacting somebody. And when it impacts somebody, it makes a difference. And thereby it needs to be used as a strategy. Soch ke banana hai, jo bhi banate ho. I will very briefly talk about, this is another book which has given me a lot of strength in context to my own thinking. So it's a very important book. It's written by a historian, Yuval Noah Harari, 21 Lessons for the 21st Century. It's a very easy book to read. So it is by a genius, but for ordinary people like us. And you should read this book because it is a book by an historian where he talks about history, about how human civilization has evolved. And because we have evolved in a certain manner, we will evolve in that pattern in the future. But he's saying that what we have seen in the past is not what we're going to see in the future. It's very different. And thereby, there are 21 lessons for the 21st century. And these lessons are for whom? For us, right? So we better read about those lessons. But effectively, what he says is that morality doesn't mean following divine commands. You know, it means reducing suffering. But end of the day, design kya hota hai? Solving problems. But what type of problems, right? Hence, in order to act morally, you need to believe in... You don't need to believe in any myth or story. You need to develop a deep sense of appreciation. you know, of suffering. And once you have that, and the, what is the term we use normally in design? People will keep telling you these things. Be empathetic. When we say be empathetic, that means you can feel the tears, you can feel the feelings of people, you can feel everything they're going through. And that is, you can feel the suffering. And once you feel the suffering of the people in the truest sense, you'll be able to design for them in every respect. You can make their life better. And design is always about making life better. The other aspect is basically, as humans, we were far better at inventing tools than using them. For people who are very, very young, this is again Yuval Noah's, Noah Harari's quotation. It would not make many sense, but one example is that we are very good at creating Facebook, we are very good at creating the atom bomb, we're creating all the inventions which we have created, but we hum uska har bar durupyog karte hain. You know, there are all the evil forces who will take everything and then turn it around to their own benefit and not necessarily on the benefit of people. Today, our state of environment, our state of a lot of things, disparity, inequality, all these things have happened because of human greed. And human greed, where they have misused everything which was created for the good of mankind. We all know future is big data, machine learning, biosciences. You know, you can't avoid this. This is going to become our life in the future, in the near future. And most of you young people will be living it as hatta katta people in future sciences, you know. So what we are saying that because of technology, we as individuals will become blindsided. And we'll have less and less control because these sciences are actually manipulating us in many, many ways. So it can manipulate us for good and it can manipulate for us for bad, both. So like what Facebook is doing, like what Amazon is doing, it knows exactly how you are doing. It knows exactly what you're going to do next because it has studied you so well. And these technologies can use for advantages and can be used for disadvantages. So, but what we are saying is that we as individuals will become blindsided because of that. As powerful people who own these tools will manipulate us in many ways. So this is basically, there's again two schools of thought that the world will anyway become good, which I believe in it, it will become good. But there are a lot of people which I also believe in that will take advantage of the same good and convert it into their advantage in terms of manipulation. And so I have only one prayer for every budding designer, that unless a great number of us come together to do the right thing, and right thing ke sahi cheez karo. Sahi cheez does not mean that you do not go and work in a corporate. Sahi cheez does not mean you go and do not work for Amazon. But when you're working for a corporate and when you're working for an Amazon or when you're working for a social project, then make sure that you're not doing the right thing. You are the right gatekeeper. You become the gatekeeper. You know, what to let it happen and what not to let it, where to raise the flag and when not to raise the flag. Yeah, so I'm cutting short that part here. I'm going to skip all this, sorry. That's a little bit about my story. I was born in a very normal middle-class family. This is why you see us all suited and booted, is because it's Christmas. And in Christmas, with the best of the best clothes come out. And my father was very lucky to go to Germany just that particular year. So you see, he's in a German suit. My sister and everybody, all of I got a bow tie, which is made in Germany. But we are living in a house which is basically a very small room. So what you see is a single room house, which is our bedroom, our living room, our kitchen, our bathroom. Everything is in that room, you know. And it's probably basically a 12 feet by 8-9 feet room, you know, which is as big as the room I'm currently sitting currently now. But I was born in this house and I consider myself extremely lucky that I was born there in a chawl, because jab hum chawl mein paida hote, to hum asli dunya samajhte. You know, we understand what is real life in many, many ways, because we were probably in this attire, the best well-to-do family there in that chawl. But even we were in a small room. My father used to work extremely hard to feed us and to send us to school. And his greatest possession happened in front of my eyes, where he got himself a cycle. So that was a big thing for him and a big thing for me also. And main usko leke ghumata tha once I became a little bit bigger. So this is a picture of when I grew up, and I got admission into NID, and this is just as I was going to pass out from NID. And so NID was a big awakening, just like any design school. It will be a big awakening for all of you guys. But you also grow your hair in the bargain. I have something to say regarding all this is that I am among 1.3, now maybe 6 or 7 billion people, sitting in front of you and giving you this lecture or talk, you know, and you guys are all listening to me. And one among these many billion people is just to say that I'm very, very lucky to be sitting in front of you. You know, I could have been a garage guy, or I could be kind of a drug addict by now, you know, because I had no money to earn or something like that. And I can easily place myself into other people who were next to me in my chawl, you know, what is happening in their life currently versus what is happening in my life. So I consider myself extremely lucky and very humbled to be in front of anybody whenever I speak. And that is very important for each one of us to realize that we are born by chance. Our talent is by chance. Everything is by chance that you get that talent. Ye aapki nahi hai, ye deen hai. You know, it's a luck which comes to you. And how do you use that deen is very, very important, you know, in your life. And what you make out of it is a different thing. So people who have talent should use it well and for the right purpose. People who are not born with talent, not everybody is equal, should try and make better of themselves. You know, so mere paas sab kuch nahi hai, kuch hai. Par usse main bahut kuch banata hun. So I work very hard to make it possible for myself and for everybody around me. So this is what my company is called. It's called after my name. And I started it many years back where design was not reliable. So I said, main apna naam dal deta hun. And very broadly, because I like to do many things, as I said earlier, we say, what does Lope Design do? It does everything. Everything design is what we do. And if you look at our portfolio, then it has got a very wide variety of work. It's because it is our thinking which leads us before our craftsmanship or our expertise. And that is what I believe in very deeply. Blinking all over again. If you notice, the blink has become black instead of white. But that was just for fun. No gyan in that. I'm now going to show you two case studies. You know, I don't show work, I show case studies because kaam to behtareen kaam aap kahin bhi dekh sakte, Google mein jaake Google, you can Google and see the best and the best of the work. There are people doing really great work. But if you go through a process of how, not literally how that work, but what constitutes that work, and take it from say a person whom I was part of the team in both these projects, then you get a different insight and a different point of view in terms of what journeys creates a certain type of output, what thinking goes behind complex projects. You know? So one such project is Bihar Museum, and this is the case identity which we designed for the Bihar Museum. We were invited to bid for this particular project among the best of the best in the world, and we were lucky to get it. We also worked very hard for it besides being lucky, and we got it. And so this whole thing is about the Bihar government wanting to create the museum basically as a place of pride, you know, and they brought in two very big, tall experts, and consultants, which is the Lord Cultural Resources. They were museum experts, and Maki and Associates, they were architects from Japan. So Maki won the bid from all the best of the architects in the world. Had come to bid for this project, and Maki and Associates won it. So the building is made by Maki and Associates, while Lord Cultural Resources did the entire project management and envisioning of the entire project. And we were the third consultants which are selected, who were designing the entire brand strategy and the branding of the project. So I'll quickly take you all through the journey of what constitutes this project. And the whole idea was, I do not know how many of you are from Bihar or know Bihar as a state, but it has got a beautiful story, and that's all I can say for now. I'll take you through that journey a little bit. So the history of Bihar is pertinent to understanding the evolution of India. The mission of Bihar is to revive its lost glory. So our study of the history to so we studied the history of Bihar to examine its unique characteristics, and that's what the first thing what we did. So the position of Bihar is in an ancient India as a seat of power and culture and learning is undeniable. So this place was a hotbed of superlatives at that point of time. So let's say about 2000 years back. It is a place of genesis, a terrain that nurtured fertile thought that led to the way of life and highly evolved civilization. Many dynamic moments and important agents came from that red region. The Mauryan dynasty, the Ashoka, the Nalanda, the Buddhism, Jainism, lots and lots of things came out from that region. You know, great people came out from there. The academics, the intellects, the poets, the kings. So what perspectives does this give us? And here I'm shortening the presentation by 50 slides, you know, as I speak. And it says basically, so we came up with this understanding that the discovery of past happens through varied perspectives of scholars, historians, and academics. So jabhi bhi hum past jaate hain, whenever we go in the past, we have to depend on somebody else's interpretation of what happened. Nobody knows what actually happened 2000 years back. You know, or even 1,000 years back, and there was no written scripts which are still existing, and even if there were written scripts which are existing, which we see in temple walls and all other places, they have been written at the orders of a king, you know. So it is top down. It is somebody's story is the way they wanted the world to see the story. It is not necessarily the real story. Not necessarily the real story is very important for us to understand history from that perspective. And we told the client at that point of time that it would be wonderful if history were only true. You know, history would be a wonderful thing if it were only true. And this is very critical that as people, as human beings, as designers, as thinkers, that we understand that not everything written is absolutely true. We have to examine it ourselves. And the moment we examine it ourselves, it leads to questioning. And when we lead to questioning, then we are talking about doing the right thing in that sense, you know, is looking at things with newer perspectives. So an example is what we say is that the Yakshi was found in 1917. She was a very, very big find for India. Forget Bihar, you know. And Yakshi went through all the big museums across the world, you know. And she was insured for hundreds of crores. I don't know how much. But she went across all of the world. She was a very, very big find, you know. And what we are saying is that what we can see is that our interpretation of a Yakshi could be that one hand is sweeping away of ignorance, which is true from the Buddhist understanding of why what she's holding in a right hand. But what we are saying is that we will never know what her left hand was doing, you know, because it is broken. And even if we found the Yakshi in full form, we would never know the context around which she was placed there, you know, in that sense. On the other hand, again, coming back to Bihar, the symbols of Bihar, you know, are our national identity, which you see the Dharam Chakra, the Ashoka pillar, which comes from the Ashoka pillar, you know, which is also part of our national flag. The national flower also comes from the same region, from the Ashoka pillar, you know, which is the inverted lotus out here. And our all currency notes are full of symbols from Bihar, you know. So extremely rich, and India has borrowed its richness from Bihar, you know, its symbolism from Bihar. So what tenets or what insights does this give to us? So we are saying that how can we look at all this as a bridge to the past, and how can we build a future in context to that? So it's often said that history repeats itself. Can this knowledge ignite the future? Can the museum influence the well-being of society? Can Bihar shape our greater destiny once again? Because we all know when we say Bihar, it is almost like a bad word, right? To Bihari type of thing, you know? And if you go to Bihar as a state also, you'll see a lot of poverty, a lot of impoverished people out there, you know, who do not get this so-called opportunity which they are getting as people. Few of them come out and everybody is striving to do well in that state, but yet history, you know, right before starting from the British's rule, and even before that. I mean, that's where the downfall of Bihar started happening, and it could not recover. And but what we are saying is that can this museum become the trigger? Can it become the catalyst for awakening Bihar once again? So we studied, of course, we did a lot of study, a lot of research, and through that, basically, we came up with this representation diagram, which I'll show you, of what one museum can do in context to Bihar. So I'll leave this slide a little bit longer so that you can read it. And you can see how one element and the other element can combine and make more meaning and more outputs. So this is how strategies work, you know, in real time terms. We also looked at what Maki had done in terms of the building style and the entire flow of the entire architecture. And he was more journey oriented, more Buddhism oriented in terms of journey, learning, expanse, and thereby symbolism through that. We looked at who's this target audience for Bihar Museum. So right from the local Bihari coming from a village would be very proud of this entire history when he passes through the museum, to an expert coming from the US or a pilgrim coming from Japan or China, you know, the Buddhist pilgrim. So it would be an extremely wide audience which we were talking to. And we tried to map it, and it turned out to be an extremely complex mapping of the audience. In terms of who our target audience was for this job. Then we put certain questions to ourselves. So we are questioning ourselves, why does it excite us to come to the museum? Why will you and I come up to the museum? You know? And so we brought in different stakeholders, which is AIIMS for Bihar. I'll quickly go through this. I'll only stop. AIIMS for cultural tourism, AIIMS for preservation, AIIMS for entertainment, because the museum competes with everything else, including Netflix these days. Hum Netflix chhod ke museum kyun dekhna jayenge? And most importantly, AIIMS for youth. You know, it's a, how do we address the younger generation? How do we imbibe history and culture into the younger people? How do we create a sense of self-identity? Most important, a lot of young people are seeking identity and they don't find it. So the entire strategy hinged on this particular aspect, that can the museum can become a gateway to the past and a portal to the future. So once you pass through the museum, it'll give a sense of identity to you as a person, it'll give a sense of reference to you, and propel you into the future in that sense. So what's the essence of all this? So what we have seen through all our studies is that it was a great center for governance, way of life, and learning. You know, three pillars which support ancient civilization. So literally it looks like this. So that your body, mind, and spirit was taken care of at that point of. So body by good governance, mind by supreme knowledge, and spirit is by, you know, way of life. And when you have these three things together, you don't need anything else as far as society is concerned. It is the best place to be in. And thereby it is the ultimate abode. And Hindi mein usko kehte hain Param Vihara, the ultimate abode. So that's what Bihar was at once upon a time, the ultimate abode. So we said, ye kahani to bahut sundar hai, strategy bhi ban gayi hamari. Client maan rahe humko. These are several presentations combined together. And every time we were showing it to the chief secretary of Bihar, a room full of about 60 people in the room, you know, we are presenting them. And every time we present that, they are all agreeing to what we are saying. You know? And so far they have agreed to everything what we have said. You know? And saying, now if this institution is so powerful, so great, you know, to uska personality kya hona chahiye? Ye Amitabh Bachchan ka Amitabh Bachchan hai, to uska personality kaisa hona chahiye? You know? So this museum is open and flexible, friendly and approachable, wise, which is knowledgeable and responsible, magnanimous, strong and nurturing, lively, inspiring and interesting, progressive, dynamic, you know. So this type of personality is a seriously a great personality to have all these qualities in you in this manner, you know. And we are saying this is the quality which the museum should imbibe as a personality. And this is a slide we specially prepared for the client to say that the real museum experience is what you see in the center, in the museum experience. This is the physical experience. But today, the experience is largely virtual equally. You know, it's largely more a virtual this thing. So it's like, I give an example of Taj Mahal. I said, everybody knows the Taj Mahal story. Everybody has seen the picture of Taj Mahal. Everybody wants to come to the Taj Mahal. But I think out of all the people in the world, only 1% reached the Taj Mahal and visited in real terms. So the museum needs to be developed virtually also. You know, that is what we were telling the client. So how will this museum behave? Aap jab wahan pe jayenge museum mein, to how will it behave with you as a person? So we also try to create the behavior document, you know, so which will educate or which will train everybody in Bihar Museum, all the people who are servicing you, to behave in a certain manner. And we had a lot of big problems creating this document internally in our studio. And we said, how will we change this Bihari to behave in a nice manner to its customer, you know? And very tough to give him instructions. Ya pehle salam karo, ya namaste karo, baad mein ye karo, baad mein ye karo. And which is very typical. And I said, very few people will follow instructions or like to follow instructions in that manner. So we came up with a very unique document. And the document is a very small book. It's smaller than A4 size. Bahut choti si, mera palm se bhi chota, you know? And it says, I am Bihar Museum. And we wrote the entire behavior document in prose, you know, in first person. And he said, and we told the chief secretary that, you know, ye kitab sabko padhao. Apne aap logo ko pata chal jayega ki kaise behave karna chahiye, you know. So he says, I connect with each individual at his or her level. A child will find me playful. A historian will find treasures in my archives. A visitor will be excited to learn about the stupendous glories of this region. A mother will be able to teach her children the fantastic stories of king, crafty counselors, spiritual men who made their journey to this land. And it goes on and on like this in first person. And we were about 7 of us presenting that day to the chief secretary, you know. And I read this first paragraph and I sat down and my colleague stood up and read the other two paragraphs and so on and so forth. And I could see that everybody in the room had goosebumps on their hands. Because it was touching them so beautifully. And the book ends with saying, I hold as much parts together that could be found. It is not all of it, but then it is for you to decipher, to fill in the blanks, to find Bihar, to find yourself. So it's a very touching document to whoever reads it. And when you get touched in this manner, then your behavior changes towards how you need to behave in context to Bihar Museum. So effectively, all what I've said is actually brand strategy and brand strategy is equal to, so what we're saying, brand is equal to reputation, and reputation is how others perceive us. I can say I'm Amitabh Bachchan, but aap sab log mere ko hasna shuru karenge because I'm not Amitabh Bachchan. So that's the big problem, that we always want to project ourselves as something people perceive us different. You know? So that's equal to is very, very difficult. And what are these three equal to platforms which help us in creating that reputation? Is identity, behavior, and performance. You know, these are three things. And a brief glimpse about what is identity. Identity is not your logo. Identity is what you believe in and what you stand for. Our personality and how we express it, that's your identity. You know, your behavior is how we act and behave, the relationships we form, experiences people have of us. And performance is what do we do and how do we deliver it. Performance is also equally important. And the value we deliver. You know, कोई 5 रुपए का टिकट ले रहा है तो उसका पैसा वसूल कर रहे हो कि नहीं. So as I said earlier, projection is equal to perception. These are two very different things. You know, can I project myself as something? आप मुझे गधा समझते हो सामने से. So that's the equal to is very, very tough. You know. And likewise, we did the entire document for Bihar Museum from a strategy perspective. You know. And what does it lead to all this? So this becomes an extremely powerful brief for the design team, you know, for me to start designing the identity and the entire system. So सो वेरी क्विकली आई विल वेरी क्विकली शो यू आइडेंटिटी बिकॉज ये देखने लायक चीज है तो देख लीजिए इस पे ज्यादा बोलूंगा नहीं. So we struggled a lot to design the Bihar Museum identity. I said this identity has to be telling the story of Bihar and not something which I've learned in college, how to make a logo, you know. So this identity has many, many stories built in it. And I said Bihar Museum is not in a hurry to tell you the story. It is there for the lifetime. You know, it will be there for centuries, Bihar Museum. And it can keep telling its stories from time to time and what this logo is about. This is what it looks like on the walls of the Bihar Museum. They use a material called cotton steel. So it's a special steel which rusts over time and the color keeps changing. It will become richer and richer. We did a very elaborate guideline book. You know, we played a lot of emphasis on how you should write and speak because that's what your brand is about. All our visual material always had Devanagari script inside because I said if anybody who does not understand Devanagari looks at this, then they should know that they have to see the India and its stories through India. So usko samajhna padega. They are beautiful things, but there is a lot of richness behind these beautiful things. And also, I'll show you in the previous slide that why. Yeah, so here there's a word called Pratik, you know, and what we are telling that there are many meanings to the word Pratik when it comes to India. Ek jawab nahi hota koi cheez ka, bahut sare jawab hote hain, you know. And so here we have given example of glory, power and empire. So Pratik means all three and many more, you know. So this came out in all newspapers across India. This was the opening ceremony. This is on the entrance. This is during the opening. This is their brochure, so which is in English, but you see the dominance of Devanagari script out there. This is the invitation card. This is a wristbands for children. This is the tickets. We said we should have several types of tickets. So when 5 people, 10 people come, sabko alag alag ticket milta hai. Usko bol tujhe kya mila hai? That's good enough. So one very important thing when you visit museums, you always take museum back with you. You know, to aap kuch na kuch le jayenge to tell people ki main Bihar Museum gaya tha. You know, and that's the story you take back. And thereby the story you take back is something very unmoldable. We also did something called the wayfinding and signage system. Again, it's a science in itself. And that's also an expertise we have as a studio. So this is the whole sign family. It's very contemporary and modern. In context to the branding, because this it was very early decided by Maki, the architects, and us, and along with the client, we said that we'll align with the building architecture rather than the branding. And also the strategy was because the branding work and the signage system work happened parallelly, so the logo was not out at all. We did not know what we were going to do, so this strategy worked very well for us. So this is a totem pole. We wanted to make a totem pole which is extremely thin but extremely strong, because gaon gaon se log aa rahe the, usko hila dete, upar chadh bhi baithte. So how do you make a totem pole which is very powerful yet very elegant and strong? So this is what it looks like. You can see there, but structurally it is extremely strong. It looks very delicate. We also designed the entire website, which is responsive in nature. So it can open on a mobile, it can open up a laptop, or it can open on a tablet. And again, we went through a very rigorous process in designing the website. And we compared the website to all the best museums in the world in terms of how do they facilitate, at what levels, and how do we do it, you know. The positioning, the system architecture, the wireframe design. This is what your templates look like. This is what the populated website looks like. It would take care of anybody and everybody who comes onto the website. And these are, this is an extremely large museum, and they have many, many programs. And how do you, you know, create a system which can take in all this information? And it keeps growing as a repository. Yeah, we also did the social media and the entire social media strategy. So this is what social media looked like. Huh. That's a long break and a blink. I'm going to drink some water.
Please.
Now I'm going to show you another project. I mean, I have several projects which are very different in terms of the thinking and what direction we take because of that thinking, you know. And the thinking is very, very authentic and true to itself and to the journey which we take. But I'll show you a very different type of project now in context to a very, very recent client which we had, and name is Nestwé. I don't know how many of you all must have heard about Nestwé, but Nestwé is a very young company, and so it's one of the fastest growing company which is into home rental network. So they give you better rental solutions in context to young people largely. So people who migrate from one place to the other, so jaise aap college pass karenge to naukri ke liye aap puri desh dhoondenge, you know, for a job. And wherever you get a job, then the next thing you'll do is search for an apartment to stay in. Ab job to pehli job to lakhon rupaye ki milti nahi hai, so you get a few thousand rupee jobs, 20,000, 30,000, 40,000. But then you would want a smaller place which could give you accommodation. So Nestwé would be the right place to give you shared accommodation. You know? So you could take a one room in a three bedroom, or you could take sharing accommodation in a single room, or you could take the whole apartment where if your father is very rich. You know? But Nestwé provides all these combinations. So what becomes is basically that every individual becomes a migrant. Wo apna ghar chhod ke kahin aur jata hai, you know. So, and the problem with migrants is basically that when you are a young person, then you have to leave everything behind. Pehle to apne maa ko chhodega piche, which is a most terrible thing. She has been pampering you all your life. Then all your friends, all your clubs, you know, football club, ya jo bhi khelte ho, you know, all those your gali wala friends, everybody you have to leave behind. And when you're going to a new place, you become very you're unfamiliar with this. You're uncomfortable in such situations. So what we told Nestwé, that there's a fantastic opportunity for Nestwé to make them feel comfortable in a new place, you know, and welcome. So if we take care of the basics, youth can then pursue their aspirations, dreams, and goals in a nurturing space. So can Nestwé become a nurturing space for people? Kamra to deti hai, sab facility to deti hai, but can it be do little things which will make you feel that comfortable? You make you feel back at home, you know. And typically, when we studied what Nestwé does, I mean, most of you maybe know about Maslow's hierarchy needs. This triangle will be very, very famous in your design career. It always tells you where you're positioning, you know, your services or your goods. You know? And Nestwé basically handles the bottommost three most important aspects, you know, which is your physiology, your safety, and your love and belonging aspects, you know, of your needs. And that's where Nestwé was very well positioned to do something about it as a brand. And we told that, you know, that Nestwé can do something very powerful with its branding, you know. So we at Nestwé excel in providing basic amenities for young urban migrants. We help them build open platform towards fulfilling a sense of belonging. So open platform is very different from the platform which we are used to as in your home. In your home, you had a platform which is your parents, your teachers, you know, your mentors, you know, people who told you what you should do right or versus wrong. An open platform is saying, ke ye maidan hai, abhi aap kuch karo us maidan mein, you know. and they'll throw a football inside. So you'll figure out what to do with that ball. You may decide not to play football. You may decide to do something else, you know, or you may keep the ball aside. So we're saying that can NestWave become this body which can actually create platforms for you, and it is up to you. You decide what you want to do. So these platforms are catalysts enabling young urban migrants to explore and create their own worlds. So we did all this study and bahut sara bhashan karte rehte hum log in our presentations mein. But what does it lead to is I'm going to show you now. And this is the first presentation we did to the client. Ditto wahi main bata raha hu jo maine client ko dikhaya tha. In terms of identity, ki aapka identity kya hona chahiye. So we showed this one house ka picture, you know, typical house ka picture. You know, acha sa saaf sutra lag raha hai. And it's a square. So house is a box, you know. उसके अंदर हाउस लिख गया तो वो हाउस बन गया यू नो बट हाउस इज नो लॉन्गर अ हाउस व्हेन यू आर शेयरिंग विद पीपल यू नो सो इट्स अबाउट फ्रेंड्स इट्स अबाउट कुकिंग इट्स अबाउट म्यूजिक इट्स अबाउट ट्रिक्स इट्स अबाउट कॉन्सर्ट्स इट्स अबाउट टूर्स नाउ इफ आई गिव यू टू डू यू मे प्रॉबली कम अप विद अ डिफरेंट लिस्ट But houses many things to many people. You know, for example, houses about celebration, about making new friends. It's a strange city which you have come into. Awesome destination. So when you look at something in one perspective, you can easily change perspectives by flipping it. You know, so strange city becomes awesome destination just by flipping it. Smart connections. Great deals. Strange cities is about tribes. The world is full of small, 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 small tribes, and you belong to some tribe or the other. Inviting friends over. Home sweet home. Simple. Active community. जो हिंदी में कहते हैं ना छप्पर फाड़ के impact the world. And so we created a very simple identity. It is so simple that it never got any awards. किसी ने घास नहीं दिया इसको. All the great experts told this is very simple. This is ये कोई design होता है इसको. But I'll come to it what we really did. So we created an identity which is hugely flexible. You know, you can stretch it both ways, but it is not about stretching and putting some color inside. It is about content. You know, so this is an identity which speaks to you. You know, and this is the first time where in any page or in an advertising billboard or anything. You know, the identity is not one little signature in the bottom. आप एड्स देखते हो भयंकर ब्यूटिफुल एड्स शाहरुख खान आता है यू नो उसकी हीरोइन को घुमा के लेके जाता है यू नो एंड में बेसिकली एक छोटा सा लोगो एंड में आता है देन यू से एड किसका था किसको याद नहीं रहता तो दिस इज द फर्स्ट टाइम वेयर द एड बिकम्स द कंटेंट द लोगो बिकम्स द कंटेंट इन इटसेल्फ देयर इज नो वे यू कैन एस्केप इट इट इज हाईली कॉन्टेक्चुअल टू द फ्रेम जैसे ये ये नेक्स्ट वे 100% है आप भाग नहीं सकते हो सी द फ्लेक्सिबिलिटी ऑफ हाउ द ब्रांड इज स्पीकिंग टू यू हाँ हर हॉस्टल में रूल्स होता है ना तो हाउ डू यू टॉक अबाउट दोज रूल्स तरीके होते हैं A अगर कोई स्कीम होती है तो कैसे बताना चाहिए स्कीम के लिए? There's a concert. So Nestle provides utensils, you know, बर्तन देती है आपको. How do you talk about it? This is a little joke on left brain, right brain. But these are magnets which we give people in their houses. So you can use the magnets effectively. They can, we can start talking. So all Nestle people are called Nesties. Again, we spoke about thin slicing before, you know. So this particular ad will be only understood by Bengalis. तो बंगाली में आप बंगाल जाएंगे तो वहां पे कोई माँ अपने बच्चे को घर के बाहर निकलने नहीं देती है विदाउट हैविंग बोरोलिन इन द बैग. कि बेटे कहाँ जा रहे हो, दिखाओ मुझे बोरोलिन है कि नहीं बैग में. तो वो बच्चे को बोल रहा है कि बोरोलिन बैंगलोर में भी मिल रहा है, आ जा. सो दिस इज कॉल्ड थिन स्लाइसिंग. हाउ डू वी नीड, एंड दिस इज व्हाट आई वाज टॉकिंग अर्लियर, दिस एंटायर ब्रांड आइडेंटिटी इज फॉर इंडिया, इज फॉर इंडियंस. इट इज हाउ वी कैन थिन स्लाइस एंड डू मिलियंस ऑफ मैसेजेस. अगेन दिस टाइम टेबल वाला, जा सिमरन जा, 8 बज गए. ये सिर्फ थोड़ा सा दिमाग चाहिए, कोई डिजाइनर नहीं चाहिए इसको बनाने के लिए. एंड दिमाग क्या, सेंसिटिविटी टुवर्ड्स योर ऑडियंस, राइट? सो वी क्रिएटेड दिस कैरेक्टर विच इज यू नो वन फाइन आफ्टरनून, एंड आई विल शो यू हाउ द क्लाइंट हैज यूज्ड दिस वेरी वेरी इफेक्टिवली. This is launching in Bombay and Chennai, you know. Holi kaise dikhayenge hum? Discrimination is a big issue in our country. Aap ladki ho, single ho, aap try karo makan lene ke liye. 10 sawal puchhenge and sent wale. None of their business to ask questions. But yet they will ask. Again, we created a very elaborate system for Nestle. Although it looks simple in its outlook, it's very well worked out. This is a brand book we made for employees. Chota sa book. You know, this studio likes doing chota things. Badi badi cheez karne ki zarurat nahi hai. Chote se cheez se badi baat kar sakte ho. So who are we? So we are changing. Again, we play a lot of attention to language. Jo aap kehte ho, very important how you say it. We are changing how India lives, you know, and so on and so forth. So we gave them the manifesto. So what is manifesto? It's very simple. A, B, C, D. A for affordable. So it's very simply written there. It says, we rent homes for easy, practical and affordable living. Sense of belonging, supportive community. And D kya hoga? Any guesses for what is D? D is for design led. And we converted that entire company into a design led company. But how did we define design? Ye cheez dhyan rakho. We say that we solve new challenges with creative strategic approaches. That is design, not sundar tikao. Empathy, very critical, and so on and so forth, future ready. So what are we like as people, you know, as a brand? So we created this large poster. These are very large poster, 30 inches by 40 inches posters, you know, and we took great personalities. But on the opposite page, what you see is Sai Baba Bora. He has the same qualities which Einstein has, and his story is written there. And Sai Baba Bora is from Nestle. So we bring a large personality like Einstein, and then we bring another guy who jo apna aadmi hai, jo same quality hai uske paas, and we celebrate him. So always wo so bolte na ki superhero to superhero, I am not a superhero, but we find superheroes in people. And likewise for each quality, we found a superhero in their office and we celebrate them. Is my favorite. Be water, my friend. And this is my favorite. It's the end. In the end, we ask every employee to give a promise. So the promise is a very simple language. It's my promise. I pledge to make everyone feel at home. Yes, everyone. Feel what the customer feel always. Set the right expectations every time. Deliver what was promised no matter what. Be simple and genuine as transparency builds trust. Be proactive always because small surprises bring smiles. Smile always as it can move mountains. Not very difficult things to do. Generally showing you how it looks as a brand and how it communicates. आराम की नींद खा सकते हो नेक्स्ट वे में. सो अगेन देयर इज समथिंग कॉल्ड ब्रांड आर्किटेक्चर. एज यू लर्न मोर यू विल अंडरस्टैंड ब्रांड आर्किटेक्चर. एंड सो वी डिजाइन द एंटायर एंड बिल्ट द एंटायर ब्रांड आर्किटेक्चर फॉर नेक्स्ट वे. So what does a brand look like outside itself? So this is what the Nestway building looks like, and we put, because there are great good people working in Nestway, wonderful minds are there. You have a lot of people who come as service people for Nestway, for the apartment. So we wanted to give dignity to all the people who serve people, you know. So this is a technician's jacket, and we had different types of technician's jacket, you know, khas aadmi, bindas, क्लीन कैट्स. फिर उनके बैग्स जो होते हैं, जो प्लम्बर का बैग होता है, तो वो भी अच्छा खासा बैग बनाया हमने. और बहुत सारे ऑप्शंस दिए, बिकॉज ये नेस्टवे ब्रांड ऐसा है ना, इट्स वेरी इजी टू गिव लॉट्स ऑफ ऑप्शंस. देन दे हैव पीपल हु कम एंड स्वीप योर हाउसेस, यू नो. तो वो अपना झाड़ू और पोछा सब लेके आते थे घर के अंदर, तो कैसे देना चाहिए वो झाड़ू पोछा, you know, कैसे ले आएगा वो. How do we create dignity for these people? And this Nestway was already doing. वो गिटार में डाल के लाते थे सब कुछ. इसके अंदर झाड़ू पोछा होता था. And I think that was a very wonderful thing. तो अभी Nestway के मकान के अंदर क्या होना चाहिए? Nestway का लोगो होना चाहिए, डूज एंड डोंट्स का पोस्टर होना चाहिए, सही ना? तो हमने बोला कोई पोस्टर नहीं होना चाहिए अंदर, व्हाट टू डू एंड व्हाट नॉट टू डू. हाँ, यंग पीपल नो हाउ टू टेक केयर ऑफ देमसेल्व्स, पर कुछ तो होना चाहिए ना. दिस इज फॉर द बॉयज रूम. सो वन थिंग वेरी क्रिटिकल इज ह्यूमर, यू नो. वी हैव टू, एंड नेस्टवे इज ऑल अबाउट ह्यूमर, अबाउट ऑन द लाइटर साइड ऑफ लाइफ. सो ऑल सिटीज हैव ह्यूज वाटर प्रॉब्लम्स, यू नो. सो दिस इज ऑन द मिरर एंड स्टिकर देयर. Close the tap while you smile. सबको आदत है ना टैप खोलने की और फिर भूल जाने के लिए. ब्रश करते रहेंगे, अपने दांत देखते रहेंगे. This is when you are leaving the house to remind yourself to shut down everything. The bill तो आपको ही भरना पड़ेगा. This is again a sticker magnet. This is basically iCard which you get when you come to Nestway. We treat everybody like kings. And as partners, so let's make history together. This let's make history is actually a line of Lupe design, but we gave it to our client. Topi baantna, to alag alag topi baante, which make people feel very good about themselves. This is a raincoat. It has got double meaning. Everything has got interesting meanings about themselves. T-shirt. This is my favorite. This is also my favorite. इसका कोई अंत नहीं है, यू नो, पता नहीं हमने कितने टी शर्ट बना बना के दे दिए उनको, मर्चेंडाइज. इट्स एक्चुअली इज व्हाट यू सी इज अ टीम्स वर्क. ओके, ये सिर्फ मेरा काम नहीं है, और मेरा काम तो ये बहुत सारे लोगों काम कर रहे थे. एंड पर वो जब जैसे मतलब दे वर ऑन अ हाई, दे केप्ट ऑन प्रोड्यूसिंग मोर एंड मोर स्टफ, यू नो, स्टॉप्ड. And we were very happy because the client was happy. We were happy. We kept giving more and more stuff to the client. And of course, they paid us for everything. And then we came up with this idea about, you know, why don't we make badges for Nestway? But these badges have a rule. Okay, if you are connecting to Nestway, we'll give you 6 badges. But you can't keep them yourself. You have to give them to someone. So you can only give a music lover a badge, right? So you're acknowledging somebody's interest, and that's a very nice way to make friends. A dog lover, a mirchi lover, chai lover. I said, "Bhot saare banaye, bhot matlab bhot banaye." Different lovers are there. Then when a guy comes to Nestway or a girl comes to Nestway for the first time, वो welcome kit क्या देंगे हम उनको? You know, छोटा सा. तो ये भी बहुत छोटा सा welcome. मिठाई देते हैं ना हमारे. तो हम क्या मिठाई देंगे Nestway? छोटा सा डब्बा, ये भी A5 से बहुत छोटा है, लगभग 4-4.5 इंच चौड़ाई में. तो खोलते ही बोलते हैं वेलकम होम. अंदर एक डब्बा होता है, आई लाइक द इंडिगो डब्बा ना, बट इट्स ए सुपर स्वीट स्टार्ट. एंड दिस ऑल द थिंग्स विच आर देयर इन द डब्बा. Too many things inside. So there's a letter from the CEO. There's another booklet inside. There is mithai. There is sweets. You know? And there's a little book which basically opens two ways. So one way it opens, it says the world of Nestway, our story. और उसको book को घुमाएंगे, पीछे की तरफ देखेंगे, तो the world of Nestway, make your story. खुद अपना story बनाओ. And it tells you about various things, how to make your story and Nestway story. चाबियां, सबके अपने अपने, सबके पास एक चाबी होना चाहिए. तो हमने बहुत सारे चाबियां बना दिया उनके लिए, की चेन्स बनाए अनलिमिटेड, सॉरी दे वर ऑल लिमिटेड. देन वी डिजाइन देयर एंटायर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, द हार्ट एंड सोल ऑफ व्हाट रन्स Nestway इज देयर प्रोडक्ट, देयर डेस्कटॉप एंड देयर ऐप. एंड द क्लाइंट ट्रस्टेड अस टू डिजाइन दिस एंटायर सिस्टम फॉर देम. सो ऑफ कोर्स आई वेरी क्विकली मूव. And so this is the functional flow, and this is the website. So when we designed the website, it was different from any other website which gives out properties or which gives out apartments or anything. It is nothing like anybody else. It has its own language, you know, the language of the youth, you know. And it had also one very big advantage, because page after page in their homepage, it was the fastest downloading homepage ever. Why? Because this is all vector graphics. Vector graphics is very, very small bytes. It's phat karke download hota hai. So that's the gift we gave our client. Okay, you type nestway.com and phat it opens, even with low bandwidth. And everything was designed to the T in terms of content. And we also designed a very unique system for them, which they have still not implemented, and I won't talk about it, which would make them very, very unique in terms of how they give out their services. And when you go inside, then you start seeing stuff, you know, in terms of different apartments. This is what the app would look like. This is the 404, which a lot of us know what it means. And here I want to show another slide. Just a sec, I'll just escape. So when the website was launched, we kept on looking at the website क्योंकि हमने डिजाइन किया था और वो अपना अपना दिमाग लगा रहे थे. So we were very nervous about क्या कर रहे हैं website के ऊपर. One fine day we discovered this soon after the launch that they had dedicated a page to people who created the new look. And if I scroll down, and ये आज की तारीख है, this website was done I think a year and a half back now. I found my own face there and I found the faces of all my team members there. तो ये मेरी जिंदगी में कोई क्लाइंट ने किया नहीं था. You know, that they put our faces right out there, you know, acknowledging our contribution to Nestwave. और बाद में हमारा पूरा पलटन आ गई. Then there is their marketing head who had hired us, Rishi Dogra, and then he is the founder, you know, Amar and Deepak. These are all the founders coming after us. So that's the credit which they gave us, you know, and I keep showing this off because it is important we understand that this is the value we gave Nestwave. Okay, this is their entire team which was involved, the technical guys, and I'll show you one more slide what has happened to Nestwave since then. Can you see this? ये Jiffy है. So Nestwave started producing its own Jiffies, the GIFs files, and it has got 106.6 million hits. It's huge. So in my earlier presentation, it was 23 million hits. So मैं तो बहुत खुश हो गया था. And I used to show out to people. देखा, Nestwave ने Jiffy बनाया. And these are the Jiffies. The latest Jiffies are here. अभी जो डॉक्टर्स डे था ना yesterday. And this is what made by Nestwave. ये मेरा काम नहीं है, हमारा काम नहीं है. This is done by Nestwave. So this is the tool we gave them. And this tool has become so famous and so popularly used, you know, that more and more people are using it in their communication, you know. And it became very, very famous because of cricket. You can see cricket down as you go down. But they did this on their own. And that's what's fantastic, you know. So I'm almost at the end of my presentation, and I know we have overrun the time. But I'm going to show you one small initiative which we started as a studio, and I am one part of that initiative with many other people. It's a crowdsourced thing which we have done, and it's called the Creative Collective of India. So when the COVID hit India, so it hit everybody, ne? Sabko. लॉकडाउन में सब बैठे थे, हम भी बैठे थे, एंड फ्यू ऑफ अस रेड द आर्टिकल बाय वन लेडी, आई फॉरगॉटन द नेम, आई बेग योर पार्डन, वेयर शी टॉक्ड अबाउट के वी इंडियंस व्हेन द लॉकडाउन जब खुल जाएगा तो हम तो पागल हो जाएंगे और ये वायरस तो चढ़ बैठेगा हमारे पर. और वो एग्जैक्टली हो रहा है अभी, चढ़ बैठा है अभी, अंदर कर्व इज गोइंग अप. सो वी केम अप विद दिस आइडिया अबाउट क्रिएटिव कलेक्टिव ऑफ इंडिया, whereby we all creative people will create communication to touch people, you know, to touch people deeply so that they behave themselves. And I started off this basically when the lockdown was happening, and it took a long time to do it. Why? Because we had to use entirely open source people. Everybody had to volunteer to do it, and it took longer than necessary. But at the end of it, we launched it. You know, so it's called the Creative Collective of India.org. And I'll show you a small video. And this video has been created by a gentleman called Vineet Panchi. He's the guy who creates nazams and dohas kehte and poetry. And he basically has created this for the Creative Collective of India. And let me see if I can come. Yeah, so that's.
We can't hear, there is no audio with this.
I'll switch on the audio. I hope.
Collective of India.org. As creative people, हमारे पास एक बहुत बड़ी ताकत होती है. हम जब कुछ कहते हैं तो लोग सुनते हैं और हमारी बात ज्यादा फैलती है, और इसके लिए हम शुक्रगुजार हैं और बाकी लोगों की तरफ जिम्मेदार भी है. आज का मेरा ये मैसेज सबके लिए है, लेकिन क्रिएटिव फील्ड के लोगों के लिए स्पेशली है. I'd like to ask all of you to take a few minutes to go to creativecollectiveofindia.org. बहुत सारे क्रिएटिव लीडर्स ने मिलकर ये इनिशिएटिव शुरू किया है. Our objective is to create impactful communications that inspire actual behavior change across India, especially at this time of crisis and COVID. We can actually save lives today through our creativity. इसके बदले में आपको क्या मिलेगा? खुशी. और as a creative soul India के लिए कुछ करने का मौका. मुलाहजा फरमाइए खुशियों की दुकान especially आपके लिए. के खुशियों की दुकान लिखा था 10x6 के बोर्ड बड़े पे लाइन लगा के बड़ी दूर तक कई हजारों लोग खड़े थे. इस बाजार में सुना था मैंने खुशी की पूरी गारंटी है, ले जाता है उतना भर के जितनी जिसकी आंटी है, खुशी की पूरी गारंटी. लगा लाइन में मैं भी, आखिर शाम के होते नंबर आया. नाम खुशी चाहे दुकान का सेल्समैन बड़ा सख्त सा पाया. बोला पहले स्टूल पे बैठो, आंखें अपनी दिखलाओ, कैसे कैसे जाल पड़े हैं इनको पहले हटवाओ. छोटी छोटी चीजें तुमको कब से दिखनी बंद हुई? बचपन वाली आंख कहाँ है, खोई तुमने, बतलाओ कैसे कैसे जाल पड़े हैं, पहले इनको हटवाओ. यहाँ पे एक इलाज है होता, यहाँ पे एक इलाज है होता, ये जो ज्यादा की बीमारी है, ले आओ वो सारी चीजें जिनको उठाना भारी है. कांधों को हल्का करते ही खुशी भी कुछ बढ़ जाएगी, ना हो जाए तो पैसे वापस, ये गारंटी हमारी है. यहाँ पे एक इलाज है होता है जो ज्यादा की बीमारी है. और बताएं एक स्कीम है 1+1 में आई है, सॉलिड खुशी का फॉर्मूला है, जिसने भी अप्लाई है 1+1 में आई है. पैकेट खोल के देखो इसमें दो खाने हैं भरे हुए. पहला वो है जिसके अंदर खुशी तुम्हारी रहती है, लेकिन ये तब मिल सकती है जब तुम थोड़ा बांट सको. दूसरे पैकेट में जो है उसको किसी को दे करके उसकी खुशी में बंधु मेरे अपनी खुशी को छांट सको, ये तभी मिल सकती है जब तुम थोड़ा बांट सको. वो जो रिश्ते छूट गए थे दौड़ में मारा मारी में, हमने सब संभाल रखे हैं, तुम शायद लौट के आओगे. उसको थोड़ा झाड़ झूड़ के नया पेंट हम कर देंगे, अंदर से मजबूत है अब तक, सब वैसे ही पाओगे सेकंड हैंड पर नए के जैसे. खुशी आज भी देते हैं, हाथों में लेकर के देखो, छोड़ के जा ना पाओगे. चलो चलो दुकान बढ़ानी है, अब शक्ल गिरा के जाना है. खुशियों की दुकान है ये, उन सबका ठिकाना है जो कि सब खरीद चुके हैं, जो कि सब खरीद चुके हैं, देख चुके हैं दुनिया को, जान चुके हैं अपने अंदर खुशी का आशियाना है. चलो दुकान बढ़ानी है, शटर गिरा के जाना है. एट क्रिएटिव कलेक्टिव ऑफ इंडिया हमारी खुशी फिलहाल इसमें है कि हम इस वक्त हिंदुस्तान के लिए क्या कर सकते हैं वो कर पाए. वी वांट टू कम्युनिकेट रिलायबल इंफॉर्मेशन दैट हेल्प्स पीपल अक्रॉस इंडिया टेक प्रिकॉशंस टू फाइट COVID-19. इवन विद ऑल द इंफॉर्मेशन अराउंड अस, अब भी लोगों को सब नहीं मालूम है. देयर आर सो मेनी इनसिक्योरिटीज वेदर टू वेयर अ मास्क और नॉट, by meeting friends, washing hands, when water is scarce, maintaining physical distance, क्या खाएं, immunity कैसे बढ़ाएं, depression से कैसे बचें, नौकरियां जा रही हैं, upskill कैसे करें, बहुत सारी चीजें हैं communicate करने को. और हमारा देश बोलता भी 20 भाषाएं हैं, तो वो एक और चैलेंज है. Through Creative Collective of India, we want to create space that answers these questions and convinces people to make the right choices. It's not easy as it sounds. मैं आपको पहले खबरदार कर दूं, beating COVID-19 hinges around conveying important public health information to our loved ones and our communities consistently. Please join the Creative Collective of India's community-run platform as a creative hero and inspire positive behavior change in communities by creating and sharing messages that is authentic, honest and respectful jo hum aur aap kar sakte hain. To chalo dukaan badhani hai, shutter gira ke jana hai. खुशियों की दुकान है ये, उन सबका ठिकाना है जो कि सब खरीद चुके हैं, हम आपकी तरह जो कि सब खरीद चुके हैं, देख चुके हैं दुनिया को, जान चुके हैं अपने अंदर खुशी का आशियाना है. Much sunshine and laughter to you, दोस्तों. All the very best.
Thank you.
Thank you so much for such wonderful work. I mean, it was.
अगर आप भी मेरी तरह एक business चलाते हैं या किसी organisation में.
It's already quite late. I think I'll just take you your some maybe another 5 minutes or something to ask you a few questions.
Yes.
Some of it, of course, you have already answered. I mean, you already talked about your journey and stuff. One question I would ask you will be about the skills that you think our designers, the new generation of designers that they should have, especially in the, you know, for the new world. Generally as a designer and specifically as a graphic designer.
So firstly, when I these are questions which are advisory questions, right? So I tell people, main khud nahi janta hu. So please take anything I say with a pinch of salt.
Right.
Because we each one has to make our own discovery. That's very important. Secondly, I think there are two aspects which is not constant in context to my world versus the young world which is emerging from young people onwards. Is that in my time there was a lot of things which were constant. Sorry, har ek jawab thoda lamba hoga. And now basically that constant is no longer a constant. It is constantly changing. So we have to learn two types of skills which are critical. One is the skills of the hand, what your hand can do through your computer, through your softwares. And the other is the skill of the mind, which is thinking. And both need to be extremely agile. So you've got to be extremely fast on learning on both counts simultaneously, the left and the right. And something which we have to learn, which I just saw it somewhere, that we have to learn how to turn our hands in clockwise. It's very easy to do this, right? But it's very tough to do this. Try it. So how do you create? How do you make both of your minds or both the left brain and the right brain powerful, and that is very important, and that together becomes a lethal weapon, and then you use the lethal weapon effectively and correctly, you'll do a lot of good.
Okay. When you are, I mean, you have been through a long journey, and I mean, as you shared, like, you know, how you grew up with your parents and stuff, and what you do now, and you know, the kind of setup you have, the kind of clients you handle. I want to ask you a before after kind of a question. I mean, of course, technically a lot of things have changed and, you know, perspectives have changed, but what do you still think that, you know, something that is still the same, I mean, then and now?
A difficult question to answer, what is still the same. I think emotions are the same. Deep inside, we cry. We cry for the same things and we laugh for the same things. And I don't think that is ever going to change in many, many ways. The rest, basically, I think there's huge amount of rapidness and change happening. I hope I'm right about these two things at least, that our emotions are going to be staying the same.
Perfect. A little bit of technical question, not technical, but I mean, very focused to a graphic designer. I mean, there are many brands and I mean, we see different kind of approach for each. What according to you will be a brand that you would say that, you know, this is a brand that, you know, gives you the best of visual experience, and what are those skills that a student or a new designer, I mean, when someone gets out of a design institute, should be having to get that experience out of a brand like that? I mean, the one you really admire.
So, difficult to say which brand I really admire. For me, it's that brand is yet to be created. because in the world around us, there are too many stereotypes, and I think most of the stereotypes does not fit our country, you know, in that sense. And thereby giving an example of brands which mimic what is happening elsewhere or are from elsewhere, I would be giving a wrong example to young people. That's one thing. So it's like I would say that brand is to be created by the young people who are joining your institute. That one thing. This other thing is basically, I think more and more people who are especially joining in the graphic design field should understand that that design or graphic design or visual communication as such, there is a word communication attached to it, and thereby it is content. You know, you're always talking about content, and it's more and more critical that you pay a lot of attention to content and thinking behind it. You know, so I would say that that at one end you need to be very skillful in creating appealing things, so it has to appeal to people, appeal both in terms of cultural context and audience which you're talking to. So be very clear about whom are you talking to, and then make sure your work appeals to them. And the other part is basically the content. Aap kehte kya, what are you saying? And that is equally important. So a lot of time the graphic designer becomes a pure artist who renders somebody else's idea, like an agency. You know, advertising agency mein jayenge, copywriter copy likhega, bada idea uska hoga, aur you will be the painter making the painting. But I think from a design perspective, that thing needs to change totally. And till it changes, basically, there's very little value which designers are adding besides being a painter. And I think young minds need to know that they have to develop huge amount of knowledge about different things, aspects of what constitutes life and what makes life happen and what makes happiness happen and how do we solve complex problems. And then you become part of that solving process. And that's why good and new things will happen.
Yeah. Since you touched upon advertising, and with my experience, I mean, when we go out as a graphic designer from a design institute and go to join an advertising agency, they have this thing like, you know, oh, you are a graphic designer, you know, you are zero in advertising. And so what do you think is, you know, the basic difference between the two, I mean, advertising and graphic design?
First of all, any creative person can join advertising, so whether you're a designer or not, so there is no barriers as such. And there are, so there's the Prasoon Pandes and the Sonal Dabras, they're all designers, okay? And they are all friends of ours. So that's not a barrier at all, I don't think so. But there are few designers who get into advertising, so that's a choice by designers. But fundamentally, the biggest difference between design and advertising, which I think, is that advertising is tactical in nature. So, आपको गाड़ियाँ बेचनी हैं, तो आप advertiser के पास जाओ, वो शाहरुख को लेके आएगा, और वो नाचेगा वहाँ पे, और आपकी गाड़ी बिकने शुरू हो जाएगी कल, सही में बिकने शुरू हो जाएगी, और बल्कि आपकी showroom खाली हो जाएगी. They are so good at making tactical advertising, and that's called tactical sales. And advertisers are brilliant in taking advantage of the weaknesses of people. Wo janta hai ki aap Shahrukh aayega ya who's the latest actress? Alia Bhatt. Ki aapke samne aa jayegi to aap pigal jayenge aur aap gaadi khareed lenge. Aur bahut sare gaadiyan khareed lete hain, you know. But I'm just making fun of it. But they are using the science of us being gullible people and effectively selling us stuff necessarily we don't need to buy. Okay, right. This is my. But they also do good work, and they are very, very creative people, and I think they do excellent work. You know? And they do work extremely fast. They are very talented people who are doing good advertising at that level. On the other hand, design is a strategic tool. You know, design abhi har baar lambi daur marta hai. So what you see in two projects of ours, they are all strategy projects. They are all branding projects. Jo overnight wo sale nahi dega. लोगों को पसंद आएगा आपका ब्रांड बट वो लंबे दौर खेलने के लिए बनाया है सालों भर के लिए बनाया है यू नो एंड दैट इज व्हाट डिजाइन इज अबाउट यू नो यू मेक वन प्रोडक्ट एंड दैट प्रोडक्ट गोज ऑन फॉर लॉन्ग यू नो एंड दैट इज व्हाई डिजाइन शुड बी यूज्ड दैट्स व्हाई राइट इन द बिगिनिंग आई टॉक अबाउट डिजाइन इज अ स्ट्रेटजी टूल एंड द मोर वी अंडरस्टैंड दैट द मोर इंपॉर्टेंस विल गिव एंड द मोर डेप्थ विल गेट इनटू टू क्रिएट एनीथिंग व्हाट वी क्रिएट
Thinking of what is going on currently, I mean, with all the lockdown in place and stuff, anything about how this situation is going to affect the future of design?
वैसे ही design मरा हुआ है. It is in a sense like basically it's a tough field not because there is no work, there is a lot of work, you know, but it is misunderstood as a tough tough thing, you know. And we think that at the time, at this point of time, COVID time, where all businesses are suffering, everybody is suffering, design should be used to the maximum. But what will happen from the other side is that budget cuts will happen. So they are going to cut design budgets, you know, all those budgets and all this. So that's the contradiction which is happening. So if you look at our website and you read something, what we are doing, what we are saying, this is the time for brands and companies to search their true purpose. You know, hum yahan kya kar rahe hain? How as a brand, what are we doing? Dig deeper and see that how we can build your brand through true purpose. Because as people, hum sabko maar padi hui. As individuals, all of us are suffering because of the COVID. We are all locked down. We are suffering in many ways than one, you know, psychologically, physically, monetarily, you know, lots of people have lost their jobs. Everybody is getting pay cuts, you know, and all those things. So it's affecting us very, very badly. There are other things which are happening because of the outcomes of that. There's violence at home is happening, this, that, etc. You know, and thereby, this is a huge opportunity for society to reflect on what it is doing, for brands to reflect on what they're doing from a long-term perspective. It's an awakening in many ways, you know, and I think design can play a fantastic role at this time.
One last question from me, which will be basically anything that you would suggest for the students, any advice you know, that you want to give as a professional graphic designer to the students who are in this field.
Again, please don't listen to my advice. But I think papad belna bahut important hai. And the papad belna does not stop ever. Everybody is ambitious. Even I am ambitious, and so are you and everybody else. We always dream of a vacation. Ke end of the day main mehnat karunga, main vacation lunga. I also dream about ke one day I'll build itna bhayankar studio banaunga aur main taang uncha karke baithunga. I'll put my legs up and I will watch my glory and happiness. That day never happened. And I'm very happy it's not happening. I'm struggling every day, but I enjoy every day of my struggle. Every day is a vacation for me while at work. You know, and that's the beauty of this field, you know. That it's so engaging, it's so beautiful, it's so powerful. I'm learning every day. So if somebody asks me, what are you? I'm a learner. Main bhi padhai kar raha hu. Every time I read a book, this is the book I'm currently reading. Because there are people who are brilliant around us, before us and around us. They are saying fantastic things which awaken us. Aankhe khul jaati hai. If you don't read them, we are living in a very narrow world. Aap us narrow world se kya karenge? So it's very important to acquire knowledge, and there is no end to acquiring knowledge. So you have to be a learner throughout. We have to be a papad belna throughout. and you have to enjoy it. So unless you enjoy with passion what you do, you'll only be doing a job in the future.
Right.
The job is not a good idea.
Before we finish, I'll just take a couple of questions from the students. One is, someone says, this is Nitish Raj asking, what do you think about graphic designs? Design helps in game design. I think he's basically asking if you are a graphic designer and if you want to be in game design, how will it help?
What's his name? Nitish.
Nitish, yes.
Hi, Nitish. So game design is a very, very big field. Okay. So as a graphic designer, purely as a skill set, of course, you can do character design, because game design is a world in itself. You know, so there are special institutions and colleges which teach you game designing. And there are even special institutes which are into character designing. So you'll have to decide basically that where does your talent lie and where you can help. You know, so right from content creation to visualizing new characters or visualizing stories, and then story building and developing the entire storyboard, envisioning the entire environment, surroundings, everything. You know, so it's a world within a world, and within a game you could have many worlds. So if you are interested in gaming, then yeah. it's endless of what you can do as a graphic designer. I'm not a gaming person, so I know nothing about gaming.
There is a little, I want to take this question. This is a little different. It's not technical. Someone says, this is Pragya Kumari. She says, I'm working hard since 1.5 years, but I couldn't reach the creativity level of my friends. I'm fed up and exasperated. Now I don't know what to do to boost my creativity.
So my Pragya. Hi, Pragya. Very good question. And I think this is the best question ever. And you're asking this questions out of a lot of frustration. And it is good that you're asking out in the open. So you and I are in the same boat. Okay. It is just that basically that you are frustrated and unsuccessful. I am frustrated and successful. But I'm joking about it. I was in the same position. I do not know which year you are in. But when I joined a design school, I was having a very bad time. I was useless. I was the worst in the class. I could not draw. Every semester, my institute used to tell me, okay, bhai, this is your last semester. Aap nahi sudharenge, toh hum tumko phenk denge bahar. So I got 6 warnings in my education career. And it took a lot of effort from my side to change it for myself permanently. Okay. And one of the important things is currently you are feeling very vulnerable. Huh? You're feeling thakawa, sad, you know, hopeless. And thereby you're very weak in that sense. So the only thing which is required for us, such people, we have nothing to lose. Aur kuch khona baki bacha hi nahi hai. Kuch kho baithe hain. So the only thing which comes is courage, himmat, and self-belief. Do cheez. कि अपने आप को मानो कि आपके अंदर कुछ है. आपने व्हेन यू जॉइन अ डिजाइन स्कूल और व्हेन यू जॉइन एन इंस्टीट्यूशन तो आप कुछ सोच से निकले हो, राइट? आप कुछ सोच के मैं है मेरे में कुछ दम. बट व्हेन योर कोलीग्स कम, जो आपके आसपास में अड़ोस पड़ोस के जो कोलीग्स हैं, जो उसके ब्यूटिफुल हैंड राइटिंग है या ब्यूटिफुल ड्रॉइंग करते हैं या इनका, तो उसके सामने इमीडिएटली हार मान जाते हैं. ठीक है, वी फॉरगेट अबाउट हु वी आर. सो माई फर्स्ट स्टेटमेंट विच आई केम विद Milton Glaser ka, wo yaad karo. We are all born with genius. There is a genius in you. There is something in you which you have to find for yourself. Okay? And I found that for myself. And that's the only thing which I found for myself is that I can work very hard. I can think a little bit, jaise main aapke saath thinking kar raha hu abhi. You know? Aur main mehnat ke liye tayar hoon. I changed it hence then. It changed, my life changed after that. You know, so you first starts with self-belief. You have to believe in yourself. You know, and there is something in everybody. Some people are better, some people are worse, and maybe you are in the less fortunate category, and consider it less fortunate because wo den wali baat hai. But wo aapko usse basically, once you realize that you do not have the skills of your colleagues or your classmates, then you have to learn how to work harder. You always can get better, and you can never fail. Nothing to worry. Bas himmat karo. And once you have courage, then you can be brave. And once you are brave, nothing can stop you.
Right. Okay, I think we have exceeded the time that we had.
A bit.
So I don't want to take any more questions. With that, I thank you on behalf of UPES and everyone else here and also the students. This was a fantastic session. I mean, wonderful work. Loved it. Thank you very much.
Thank you for having me with you. And I appreciate it and I'm very grateful.